An aspiring actor, or just want to know what makes some of your favorite movie stars tick? Listen up. David Strasberg, CEO of the Lee Strasberg Theater and Film Institute, is speaking here in Seattle this weekend. But before he starts his workshop, he stopped by Como. Thank you so much for coming by.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Pleasure to meet you. The Institute was established by your father, famous father, Lee, actor, director, teacher, longtime head of the Famous Actors Studio in New York. Tell us about how the Lee Strasberg Theater and Film Institute got started.
You know, my father created the Institute. Really, first of all, he loved actors. He loved creative people, the whole conversation around creative acts. And so he created the school as a place for people to come when they're lost, right? They're lost, they're frustrated, confused, and there really aren't enough places out there providing real training. Right? Not tricks, not something you do once and then for a week you feel good and it doesn't help you, but to really build a way to train your talent. And so he created the school as a place that would endure and do that for actors.
You know, you mentioned training, and the Strasberg name is pretty much synonymous with the method acting technique. For people who don't know, what is the method acting technique?
Well, you know, method acting, first and foremost, is personal. It's personal and it's truthful. So it's never about looking like something. It's always about like your unique voice. We want more and more of you. Not someone who looks like you or what you think you should be, but really what you've got. So our work gets very personal. And that always, we also like to engender some of the, you know, your irreverence. You know, a little rebelliousness is good. Mm-hmm. It's a good thing for a method actor because conforming will kill your talent. So we work that out of you with, you know, exercises and really encouraging your impulse to come to the forefront.
You know, when it comes to training actors, I know it can take hours. You mentioned these classes, these workshops are really intensive. So it seems unfair for me to ask you to tell us how does it work in just a couple of minutes. Can you give us examples, David?
Sure. I mean, for this weekend, for an example, we're doing 3 days. Mm-hmm. And it's really a way, you know, first I'm going to meet everybody because I don't know anyone there, right? So we're going to show up and there'll be people at the beginning of their journey and there'll be people sort of in the middle who are stuck. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to start together identifying what those habits are that are getting in the way. You know, what's that thing that you think is serving you and it's really not serving you? Or it's not serving you, it's served you so far, but you want to go further. And then we'll spend some time actually getting you to make sure you experience what your really creative voice feels like. Where is it in your body and how does it express so you can create miracles, you know, on film?
For people who enjoy watching actors do their thing, we don't know what method acting is, but we've seen the famous actors who use that method, Robert De Niro, Jack Nicholson. Famous graduates include De Niro, Mickey Rourke, but also comedians as well. And I was really fascinated by that. Will Arnett, Kathy Griffin, they do such different work. How much of their talent would you say is taught because you know what goes into it? And how much of it is innate?
Well, you know, your talent and your training, it all stacks. It all works together. So the better trained you are, the more we won't see your training. We're only going to see your talent. You know, so was Adam Sandler always funny? Yeah, he had a gift for comedic work, you know, even young. But to maximize that, you know, when you're in film, it has to be reliable. You have to do it on cue. You have to do it 10 times. You have to do it at 6 in the morning. And that's not so easy. And that takes training to make sure that those moments of inspiration come when you want them, when you need them. So it's really a balance of the two things. We like to train your talent, right? So we can't create talent. You bring it in, and it's everywhere. It's right here in Seattle, which is why I'm here.
Whether it's drama or comedy?
It's really about you. It's your voice. And you'll see people who gravitate towards one area or the other. But usually that's something you carry in your mind. Like, if you're a comedic talent, can you do dramatic work? For sure. Absolutely. But sometimes you don't think you can. You have habits that are created that tell you you can't. So part of our job is to start to work away those habits so you can do whatever you ask of yourself.
It sounds like a humbling experience.
It's humbling and inspiring. It's humbling for an actor, but at the same time, you know, there was an actress once and she was crying and my father said, "Darling, what's wrong? I'm only introducing you to yourself." And she said, "What if you don't like who you meet?"
Oh my goodness.
You know, so, you know, there is some of that. You want to get to know yourself, but also it's really about more acceptance, right? You know, that where I was talking about conformity, as long as you conform, we're not interested. Right? So you'll see great actors are always creating new moments, new little miracles that appear, and that takes a lot of courage, right? And maybe it takes more courage even than talent.
What is it that you hope students walk away from after they've completed a workshop this weekend?
You know, my job this weekend is to put your feet on a path. Right? So whether you're at the beginning of that journey, you know, this is a journey that stretched back hundreds of years because actors have been confused and lost for a long time. Mm-hmm. Right? So I'm looking at people. Some people are going in circles, and they're not sure who to trust and how to do it.